Lord God strong and mighty. For the Lord God fighting in battle. Open up. Oh, open up. For the Lord God strong and mighty. He's the great tears of the fall. For the earth is your heart.
Those who dwell
with your people. For the Lord God mighty in battle. Open up. Oh, open up. For the Lord God strong and mighty. He's the great tears of them all. For the earth is your heart. Those who dwell with your people adore. In your name.
Heaven moves. Heaven. Good morning, NY Baltimore. Hallelujah. This is the day that the Lord has made, and we will rejoice and be glad in it. If you're in your home, if you're in your room, in your living room, I just want you to lift your hands up and begin to pray in the Holy Ghost. Ramande riando rabako satama riando da ya mansoya ramando koshete riande de besuya ramansho ramande de bekusataya ramando ro ya basho mansheke de bensuraya rebekusatanda mansikia rebekshe riando manseya basho riana mansataya rebekusaya na ro ro bohosaya rebekusana mansoya rebeshitianda bansukurabahaya. Father God, we bless you and we glorify your name, God. We give your name the praise, oh God, because you are God and God alone, God. We lift up our voices unto you, oh God. We thank you, oh God. We thank you, Master, oh God, for life, God. We thank you, oh God, that you woke us up this morning, oh God, and that you started us on our way, God. God, we thank you, God, that you gave us the activity of our limbs, oh God. Father God, we thank you. We do not take these things for granted, God. But God, we pray, Lord God, we praise you and we honor you, oh God. We thank you, oh God, Lord God, that we celebrate, Lord God, Resurrection Sunday, Father. We celebrate, Lord God, that you, Lord God, that Jesus rose from the grave, oh God. We thank you, oh God, that death could not hold him. We thank you, oh God, that he took the keys of death, hell, and the grave, oh God. We thank you, oh God, that, Lord God, through the sacrifice, oh God, through the cross of Calvary, oh God, that we have been redeemed back to you, oh God. We thank you that we've been bought with a price, God. We thank you, God, that you purchased our freedom. Rebe sona manchaya, ribe novoko sataya. God, we thank you, oh God, for the blood that covers, oh God. We speak the blood of Jesus, oh God, to cover every home, God. We speak the blood of Jesus, God, to cover every family, God, every person that's connected to us, oh God. Father God, we thank you, God, that the blood prevails, that the blood prevails where men may fail. The blood prevails, oh God, where systems may fail. The blood prevails, God. We thank you, oh God, that you have all power in your hand, that you rose with all power in your hand, oh God. And we thank you that the same power that raised Jesus Christ from the dead, it is in us. It is in us, oh God. And we thank you, oh God, that we exercise our authority in the power that you place in us, God. Power to tread upon serpents and scorpions. Power over all the, Lord God, powers of the enemy. And nothing, God, by any means shall harm us, oh God. We thank you, oh God, that your word declares that if you shut up heaven, where there be no rain, and if you send locusts upon the earth, if my people who are called by my name will humble themselves in prayer and seek my face, turn from their wicked ways. We turn, oh God, we turn to you, oh God, we turn to you, Father, where we have built altars, God, unto foreign gods. We tear down those altars. We break them into pieces in the name of Jesus. We thank you that our heart belongs to you. We thank you that our mind belongs to you. We thank you, God, in the name of Jesus, that we are yours. Lord God, I thank you, God, that your word declares, God, that we may be one as you and your Father are one. We thank you that unity, Lord God, will permeate the earth, oh God. We thank you, God, in the name of Jesus, God. Lord God, for uniting us, God. And God, that we're going to come out of this stronger. We're going to come out of this better. We thank you, oh God, that even as the word goes forth on today, that our spirit will be, Lord God, fertile soil. Lord God, in the name of Jesus. And I thank you that as the seed of the word is being planted in us, God, that it will be bring forth much fruit in its own season. And we honor you and we bless your name, oh God, because you're worthy to be praised, Father. We honor your name, God. We honor you, Father, because there's nobody like you. And we give your name the praise. And we give your name the glory. It's in Jesus' name. Amen.
Come on, we're lifting up the name Jesus. It is the name that is above all names. It is the greatest name in heaven and in earth. There is no name greater than Jesus. We lift you up today, oh God, and we declare that you are the resurrection. Yes, God, that you are the way, the truth, and the life. God, we lift your name today. Jesus is the name above all names. Come on and bless the Lord right where you are and lift your voice to him. Hallelujah, hallelujah. All of earth, all of heaven, make a joyful noise. Send up a praise, no other name greater than Jesus. We lift your name up, name up. All of
earth, all of heaven, make a joyful noise.
Send up a praise,
no other name greater than Jesus.
We lift your
name up,
so we shout, oh.
The name that makes the devil flee.
Name.
We lift your name.
name.
We exalt your name.
We lift your name, name.
We lift your name.
We lift your name, name.
Hallelujah.
Yeah. Come on and shout unto your God, because he's great. Jesus, you are the greatest. There's no one like you, no one beside you. God, we thank you. We thank you, Jesus. You are the greatest. Yes, Lord. Hallelujah. And Jesus, we thank you for calling us out of our graves of depression, our graves of anxiety. God, we thank you for pulling us and snatching us out of those graves. And so we thank you for this glorious day. Yes, Lord. I was buried beneath my shame. Who could carry that kind of weight? It was my tomb when I met you. I was breathing but not alive. All my failures I've tried to hide. Yeah. It was my tomb, Jesus, till I met you. Yeah. You called my name, and I ran out of that grave.
Yeah.
Out of the darkness into your glorious day.
Yeah.
Darkness into your glorious day.
I'm living in the light now.
I'm living in the light now.
I'm living in the light now. I'm living in the light now.
I'm living in the light now.
I'm living in the light now.
I'm living in the light now.
I'm living in the light now.
I'm living in the light
now. I'm living in the light now. I'm living in the light now.
Thank you for pulling me out.
I'm living in the light now.
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 Just a blessing.
Praise the Lord.
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 Despite what I may feel, hey.
Praise the Lord.
Despite what I may see, hey.
Praise the Lord.
Your God, for the freedom that He gave you, for the liberty that He's given you. Hey, God, I'll be a living testimony for you that you saved me, that you freed me, that you sanctified me. And I'm grateful, God. Hallelujah. I am living proof of what my God can do. Yes, Lord.
Something marvelous happened to me. Whoa. I was a prisoner. Your love broke me free. I was blind in unbelief, but you made me see.
Hallelujah. Yes, Lord.
Hallelujah, I am living proof. My God is on the move.
There's nothing that He can do.
Faith rise up.
Say, I am living proof.
Breathing,
hallelujah.
on the move.
God, you are moving in this place. God, we want you to inhabit this place. Hallelujah. You are moving. Come on, press into him. Right there in your living room. Right there in your bedroom. Sitting at the coffee table. Roshai, ye keep on the levesora. Lord, we press into you. We desire you, oh Lord. We want you to inhabit us. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We praise your name because you are good and you are mighty. Hallelujah. Right there, wherever you're sitting, why don't you just clap those hands and honor your Lord. Hallelujah. We bless your name, Father, for you are good and you are mighty. There is none like him. There is none like our God, Jehovah. Hallelujah. On behalf of Apostle Yolanda and Pastor Corey Smith, we would like to welcome you wherever you're watching us from. If you can, just in the comments, go ahead and put where you're watching us from. We thank you. We know that there is so many other services that you could be watching right now, but we thank you for tuning in. And I believe that simply because you decided to tune in, there is a word for you. We are in a time where a lot of us don't know what is going on, but I believe that when we make a decision to tune into God, there is a word for us. He is always speaking. Hallelujah. So we welcome you. At this time, I have the honor to lead us into the next level of worship, which is tithes and offering. Hallelujah. When I think about tithes and offering, as I was meditating on this, I came across Jeremiah 17, 7 through 8. And it says, "But blessed is the one who trusts in the Lord, whose confidence is in him. They will be like a tree planted by the water that sends out its roots by the stream. It does not fear when heat comes. Its leaves are always green. It has no worries in a year of drought, and it never fails to bear fruit." Jay, what are you saying? I'm simply saying that it does not matter what's going on around you, but the Lord has a plan and a purpose for you, and there is nothing that is around you that can affect you. Hallelujah. As long as you decide to trust in the Lord, as long as you decide to believe that his word and his promises are true concerning you, you don't have to hold back anything. You can give every offering that you have to give simply because the Lord has a plan to prosper you. You don't have to worry. You don't have to hold on to the little that you think you have, but the Lord has something in store for you. I remember this time last year, I lost my job out of the blue. I had my boss to come in, and she told me, she said, "Unfortunately, we've had a contractual change, and we need to let you go effective immediately." I was distraught because I knew that I had a family that was depending on me. But as I gathered all of my things and I walked out of the building, I can remember being feeling discouraged in my spirit. But as I began to walk towards the train, I heard the Lord whisper, "Will you trust me?" And all I could do is say, "Yes, Lord." Within three weeks from that day, I started another job that I've been on ever since, and it is the best job that I have ever experienced. I want to encourage somebody that it doesn't matter what your circumstance look like. It does not matter where you are or what you don't know is going to happen on tomorrow, but I just want to encourage somebody and dare you to believe what the report of the Lord is concerning you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Have a few ways to give. If you would like to give, you can text 7NYBMORE to 77977. Again, that is 77977. You can also go on the World Wide Web and type in www.nybaltimore.com/donate. And you can also go into your iTunes and wherever you Androiders go. You can download their All Nations app, and you can also give that way. Amen. Hallelujah. We're going to read our declaration from wherever you are as you're giving your tithes and your offering. We're still going to say it with power. Hallelujah. We decree and declare that we are a blessed and prosperous people, and we are blessed to be a blessing because we are tithe payers. God rebukes the devourer for our sake, and the windows of heaven are open for us, and blessings are overtaking us that we have not room enough to receive. We
are good stewards of our money, and we have buying power on our dollar. We have excellent credit, and we have wisdom, knowledge, and kingdom financial management skills. We give generously, therefore it is given back to us, pressed down, shaken together, and running over shall men give into our bosom. We are lenders and not borrowers, and we owe no man nothing but to love him. Therefore, our debts are paid in full. Because we have favor with God, we have favor with man. God's favor surrounds us as with a shield. We have favor in our businesses, in our schools, on our workplace, and in the marketplace. The wealth of the wicked is laid up for us because we are a just and integral people. We break generational curses of the spirit and mindset of poverty. We decree and declare that we prosper in our mind, our health, our finances, even as our soul prospers. We call forth resources from the north, south, east, and west. We call forth jobs, houses, cars, promotions, education grants, and scholarships in Jesus' name. We decree that we are a wealthy people, and we leave an inheritance to our children's children. Our hands are blessed, and whatever we touch shall prosper. We are not fearful people, but we are faithful people, and we are walking into our prophetic Goshen, our promised land filled with milk and honey. We decree that financial breakthrough is here now in Jesus' name. Because we love God and seek first his kingdom and his righteousness, that all these things shall be added unto us in Jesus' name.
Up next, we will have a dance presentation by Kirsten Stiff of Barak Dance Ministry.
Oh, morning, Anwa Baltimore. We would like to take a brief pause from our virtual Sundays at the Well to share some brief announcements. This is your Anwa Scoop. Have you been enjoying virtual Sundays at the Well? Comment below how it's impacted you. Until further notice, remember to join us every Sunday at 11:59 a.m. on both Facebook and YouTube Live. Share our live and tag friends and family. Make sure to also like our Facebook page and also subscribe to our YouTube channel. This coming Tuesday, the prophetic team will have a training at 7 p.m. via Zoom. And while Baltimore partners, listen up. This coming Wednesday, corporate prayer will be held at 6:30 p.m. Following that will be Midweek Development Fresh Connect at 7 p.m. Both corporate prayer and midweek are held through the Fresh Connect Facebook group. Also at 7 p.m., Foundations class will be in session. For those who are currently enrolled, please make sure to look out for a Google Hangout link in your email. Anwa Tribes, be on the lookout for postings in your specific group. Anwa Baltimore, it is officially Spirit Week. Make sure to stay tuned to our Facebook and Instagram page for the lineup of events. Mark your calendars, because we have new dates for Issachar 2020, May 21st through the 23rd. God is certainly on the move. For more information, remember to visit yolandastith.com. We would like to virtually welcome all first-time viewers to the Well. Thank you for joining us. You are certainly in the right place. Last but not least, we ask that you continue to pray for our leaders, Apostle Yolanda and Pastor Corey Stith, as they continue to do the work of the ministry, even during this time. This has been your Anwa Scoop. Stay tuned for more of Virtual Sundays at the Well.
Father, in Jesus' name, I bless you and I give your name the glory. We thank you, Father, for this day that you have established even before the foundation of the world. The day that is set aside where we commemorate, where we remember what you have done. We salute you. We thank you for being the life giver. We thank you for being the one that saved us, the one that redeemed us, the one that delivered us, the one that set us free. We thank you that you are our gift to the world. You are our gift from the Father. We bless you so much for being the one that made our way. You opened up rivers and deserts and you made our way clear. And for that, we give your name the glory and the honor and the praise that is due your name. We enter into your courts with thanksgiving and through your gates with praise. I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of our God. You give us peace. When anxiety and torment is in the world, we sit with expectation that you are our deliverer. And because you are our deliverer, there is nothing that Satan can do. You ease our frustration and you quiet our storms. Thank you for being everything that we need. We give you our gratitude and we lift our voice and we say, God, come and live in the midst of us. We thank you for the blood, the Passover lamb that was slain. Jesus, our hope. Jesus, our perfect lamb that was slain before the foundation of the world. God, we lift your name up. And we say thank you, oh yes, for tearing the veil. Thank you for being our ever-present help. Thank you for eliminating every excuse that separates us from coming close to where you are, God. We say thank you for your mercy and thank you for your grace. Thank you, oh yes, that you have given us life. Thank you for the name of Jesus. Happy Resurrection Sunday to all of you, to you and your families, those who are watching. Thank you so much. I'm excited that today marks the day that we
celebrate Jesus being raised from the dead. And not only was he raised from the dead, but so were we. I celebrate the fact that I am no longer dead, but I am alive. If you're in your homes, I want you to begin to celebrate and lift up the name of Jesus, because you are alive. I thank you that even as you begin to speak that, the anointing of God will meet you in your homes in Jesus' name. Would you be so kind to turn with me in your Bibles to Matthew 20, verses 17 through 19. I'm going to preach from the theme, Jesus, today. Matthew 20, 17 through 19 is our foundation scripture. It says, now Jesus was going up to Jerusalem. On the way, he took the 12 aside and said to them, we are going up to Jerusalem, and the Son of Man will be delivered over to the chief priests and teachers of the law. They will condemn him to death and will hand him over to the Gentiles to be mocked and flogged and crucified. On the third day, he will be raised from the dead. Amen. The message of the resurrection is one of the most talked about controversial stories in the nation, and I would even dare say countries across the world. The name of Jesus and the mention of his works is banned in many, many places, but it can never be erased. It's controversial because they cannot prove that he did not exist. It is controversial because they cannot explain him away. Everywhere we go, there is evidence that Jesus was raised from the dead. It can't be erased from the hearts and from the minds of those that have encountered him. It just cannot be erased. There is tangible proof. There is proof all across the world that the supernatural man by the name of Jesus lived. Not only did he live, he died and he rose again. I am so glad to be alive, but more importantly, I am so glad to be one that proclaims the name Jesus. The message of the resurrection is a message of hope. The message of the resurrection is a message of new life, and it is the message I want to preach to you today. I want to preach to you about this man named Jesus that rose from the dead. Jesus, he is our Savior, number one. He was not just born to live, but he was born to die. He was also born to be raised again. It is the testimony of all believers that he rose from the dead. And it's a personal testimony because all of us have experienced that when we received Jesus in our heart. When we made that confession on that day when we accepted Jesus in our heart, we made the confession that he was raised from the dead. It was our personal testimony proclaimed publicly. And what Jesus did is he gave us a right to eternal life when he was raised from the dead. Not only was he raised from the dead, but in between that space where he died and he rose, he went down into hell and he took the keys of death, hell, and the grave. And when he took those keys from Satan, he took the right to charge us with anything that we had did, because his blood, it paid the price for us all. Jesus Christ, our Savior, a man who was not guilty but died to redeem all mankind. He was a man that was not guilty, but he was a man that was willing to take on guilt and take on shame as his own. He wore it, and when he wore it, he bore the weight of it so that we did not have to. In John 19, 5 through 6, it says, when Jesus came out wearing the crown of thorns and the purple robe, Pilate said to them, here is the man. And as soon as the chief priests and the officials saw him, they shouted, crucify, crucify. But Pilate answered, you take him and you crucify him. As for me, I find no basis for a charge against him. Case in point number one, he was not guilty. But there are people that were determined that they would make him guilty, that they would find a charge against him, although he was a blameless land before the foundation of the world, that it came into the world to take away all sin. But don't you know that it was on the calendar of God that he would be charged with something that he never did, so that when the day came that we would be charged, the blood of Jesus would stand strong and proclaim from the ground that we are not guilty. Yes, I'm talking about the man named Jesus. Didn't you know that when Jesus bore the guilt upon himself, it freed you from guilt and shame so that you did not have to bear it? I'm talking about the man named Jesus. I'm talking about Jesus Christ, the soul saver. I'm talking about Jesus Christ, the mind regulator. I remember being so full of shame and so full of fear and so full of guilt that I could not even think straight. All I could think about was what I did. And then all of a sudden, there was a day that I was introduced to the man named Jesus. I remember sitting on the back pew and I began to cry out. I began to cry out to a man that I had only met once in a dream that became real to me in a church service. I'm talking about this man named Jesus, the soul saver and the mind regulator. Did you ever think that you would come to the point of resolve, that you would come to the point where you would believe that what Jesus did was not just for them, but it was for you too, and it is for those of you that are watching? He didn't just come for me, but he came for you too. John 3:16-17 says, "For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, and whosoever would believe on him would not perish but have everlasting life." It was the scripture that I was saved on from a little girl, and there's a promise there. Said Jesus came not just for me, but he came for the entire world. The Father sent him into the earth for the entire world, that if any man would believe on him, they would not perish but have everlasting life. I'm preaching the message of the gospel here. For God did not send him into the world to condemn the world, but God sent him so that the world might be saved. Is there anybody listening under the sound of my voice that needs a savior right now? 1 John 4:14 says, "And we have seen and do testify that the Father sent the Son to be a savior into the world." I'm talking about Jesus Christ, the savior of the world. Come on, there's an extension. Oh yes, of the Father through the Son. When he sent him into the earth, he was sending himself in flesh form. He said, "I got to give the world a piece of me." Don't you know outside of God we are nothing? Don't you know outside of God we are as filthy rags? But the blood of Jesus Christ came to redeem us once and for all. There's such a sense of hopelessness in the earth. There is fear and there is torment all across the earth. But Jesus Christ is our hope. He is our hope in a world of darkness. He is the light of the world. Come on, somebody say Jesus right there on your chair. I want you to begin to call on the name of Jesus. The name of Jesus. Come on, open the door so that the light can come in. I'm speaking to those of you that have been burdened. You've been burdened by what's happening in the world. But today I command you to shake yourself from the burden. Didn't you know that Jesus Christ is the burden bearer? There is such power in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, demons tremble. By that name they bow. And I'm here to send the power of the name of Jesus through the airways to you and to you and to you. There is something about the power of the name Jesus. Something was unlocked when he walked through the town. There was always a ruffling. There was always a sense of unease when he would present himself in any town. They didn't understand why he was there. They didn't want him to be there. But it was because he carried a power in his presence and in his name. That commanded commanded atmospheres. And I'm here to tell you that if you would begin to call on the name of Jesus, I feel the Holy Ghost, your atmosphere would shift, resources would come. I want some people to get on the bandwagon with me and begin to call on the name Jesus. He is our rock. He is our fortress. He is our way. Come on. I feel the Holy Ghost moving. He's not just moving on me, but he's moving on you too. Come on and hear. Something was unlocked when they pierced his side. On a Good Friday, he endured death so that you would not have to. Aren't you grateful that you don't have to endure death? Jesus, come on, he bore death, he took it upon himself, and he defeated death so that you would live. There was a point on that Good Friday, about the 6th hour, the scripture said that there was darkness all over the land until the 9th hour, and at the 9th hour Jesus cried out with the voice, Eloi lo bakafaso, God, and he cried out, my God, why have you forsaken me? But it was only for a moment. And the Bible says that there was some bystanders standing around. Behold, he's calling Elijah. And I'm here to say he wasn't calling Elijah. He was calling on the Father. Why have you forsaken me? Why? Because Jesus did not know darkness. All of a sudden, he became acquainted with darkness. He became acquainted with pain. He became acquainted with sickness. He became acquainted with sorrow. He became acquainted with torment. All at one moment, the Father turned his face from him, and he became acquainted with rejection and with pain. I'm talking about Jesus, the one that bore it all. It says he went through that moment. He cried out. He cried out to the Father. Oh, yes, he did. Wait a minute, it's not Elijah that he's talking to. Jesus uttered a loud cry and breathed his last breath. And then the next thing the scripture says is the veil was ripped. It said the curtain of the temple was torn in two from top to the bottom. And when a centurion who stood facing him saw the way that he breathed his last breath, he said, truly, this is the Son of God. I'm about to tell you something. I'm about to give you a revelation. How you die will determine who you belong to. When he gave up his last breath, he moved from humanity. He stepped into the supernatural, and his spirit man went down into hell. Oh my God, and confronted the thing that had stood against him. I'm here to tell you that God has given you power in your dark hour to confront the thing that stands against you. He took upon himself our pain. He took upon himself our sin. He took upon himself our sickness. There is nothing in the earth that you will ever endure that Jesus did not bear. Oh, what a night. It was a glorious night. It was a Good Friday. Hey, glory to his name. And not only was he one that defeated death, Jesus Christ was the one that raised from the dead. 2 Corinthians 1:9-10. Indeed, we felt we were under the sentence of death in order that we might not trust in ourselves, but in God who raises the dead. Verse 10 says, he has delivered us from such a deadly peril, and he will deliver us. In him we have placed our hope, and we will yet can be delivered. I'm here to tell you, he didn't just raise them from he didn't just raise himself from the dead, but here we see the confession of Paul. They were over in the area and they begin to reflect on the power of Jesus being raised from the dead, and they begin to testify, he will yet deliver us. I want to encourage some of you that in spite of the situation that you are in, you need to begin to call on the name of Jesus, the dead raiser, and proclaim like Paul proclaimed, he will deliver us. God will come through. I prophesy that you're coming through. In John 2 and 19, Jesus answered and said to them, just destroy this temple, and in 3 days I will raise it up. He was prophesying. He was talking about his own power, but we are carriers of that same power. I want you to look around yourself. Whatever is dead in you, I want you to begin to prophesy. You're coming alive in the name of Jesus. There's a revival anointing that is going to hit your home when you begin to prophesy. The same God that raised his son from the dead will deliver us again. Come on in here. I said he's a dead raiser. Come on in here. There is absolutely nothing in your life that has died that the power of revival cannot raise from the dead. We see the picture of this in Ezekiel 37 when God begins to talk to the prophet about using his mouth. It was a foreshadow of the power that we would have as prophetic believers. Come on, I'm talking about Jesus. You've got power in your mouth to call the dead thing alive. Come on in here. You've got power in your mouth to speak to pain. Jesus Christ, he was the pain taker. Hear me what I say. Isaiah 53 and 4 says, surely he has borne our griefs and carried our sorrows. I'm telling you something. What you're asking him for has already been done. And some of you need to move beyond asking to move to the place of decreeing, because what you need from God has already been done. You've been calling out for deliverance from the pain that you were going through. I'm talking about emotional pain. I'm talking about physical pain. I'm talking about pain that resides in the soulless realm. Jesus Christ is the answer to it all. He was born to carry our griefs. Some of you are feeling a sense of grief right now, but if you would call on the name of Jesus, he will carry away your sorrows. 2 Corinthians 1:3-5 says, blessed be the God and Father of the Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of mercies and God of all comfort, who comforts us in all of our tribulations, that we may be able to comfort those who are in trouble with the comfort with which we ourselves are comforted by God. For as the sufferings of Christ, hey, abound in us, so our consolation also abounds through Christ. Listen to me. When you came into relationship with the Lord Jesus Christ, the same suffering that he had gone through, that power rests on the inside of you, not just to suffer, but to bring somebody else through. That same power of deliverance that rests on Jesus, because he came to bear our griefs, also rests on you. And I'm here to tell you that God is raising you to be a deliverer. There is no pain that Jesus can't heal. There is no sorrow that he is not acquainted with. And I'm just going down the characteristics of Jesus so that you understand that there is absolutely nothing that you will ever go through that Jesus has not already gone through. And he is in the business of making a way. John 14:6 said, Jesus said to him, I am the way, the truth, and the life, and no one comes to the Father except through me. Listen to me. You may have been negotiating before today how you would make it happen, how you would do this thing on your own, but it has been proven that all of us need a Savior, and his name is Jesus. Jesus declared out of his own mouth, listen, I am the way. What he was saying is, I am the only way. I am the truth. Everything else is a lie. And I am the life. Everything else is death. No one comes to the Father except through me. He also called himself in the scripture the door. He's saying, I am the door. I am the opening. I am the opening. I am the one that will make your way straight. I am the one that will illuminate the path. I am the one that you can trust. I am the one that you can put your hope in. We become so accustomed to not trusting God. But God says, if I can get a nation to just turn and put their trust in me, cry out unto me, in a dark world, I am the light. I am the light. I am the light. Acts 4:12 says, nor is there salvation in any other, for there is no other name under the heaven given among men which we must be saved. There is no other name. Jesus is the most powerful name in the earth. And when you call on him, he will become your answer. Listen to me. I want to petition you to take a moment. While you're sitting there, take a moment. And I want you to think about what you need Jesus to be for you. What do you need him to be for you? He is your only hope. Jesus is your only hope. And Jesus is your only breakthrough. He is the way. He's the door. 1 Peter, as I'm closing, 1 Peter 1:3 says, blessed be the God of our Lord Jesus Christ, who according to his abundant mercy has begotten us again to a living hope through the resurrection of Jesus Christ from the dead, to an inheritance incorruptible and undefiled that does not fade away, hope reserved in heaven for you. Listen to me. Jesus and the hope that he gives us through the resurrection will never fade away. The message of Jesus Christ can never be old. It is always living. It is still carrying the same power. Hope. It still carries the same power. And to those of you that are watching this, because this is what we do for Easter Sunday, I'm here to tell you that the heart of God cries out, return unto me. Hey, I am your answer. I am your light. I am your everything. Romans 15:4 says, for whatever things were written before were written for our learning, that we through the patience and comfort of the scriptures might have hope. I have given you the scripture today so that you can find hope in Jesus Christ. Let your heart be filled with hope. We are not hopeless, and we are not at the disposal of any man. But our lives is in the hand of God. Jesus still governs the earth, and the government shall be upon his shoulders. Hey, let me offer some fire. He still governs the earth. He is the Lord of all. He is the Lord of all. I am the way. I am the truth. I am the light. I am your hope. He is our everything. He is our everything. Romans 8:37, as I'm closing. Yet in all these things, hey, we are more than conquerors in Christ Jesus. And I want to tell you something, that Jesus made the way. Jesus saved the world. Jesus gave us hope. But we are more than conquerors through Christ Jesus. There is no other way. Jesus is the way. Jesus is our hope. There is no other way. There is no other way. There are many of us who had been in the church and were backslidden. Today is a day of reckoning. Today is a day of resolving. Today is a day of decision. But I want to call you into the place of decision. I want to call you into the place of return. returning to the Father. No longer churchgoers sitting on the pew, warming the pew. But God has called us to the place of position as sons of God. We are sons of God, and we can do all things through Him because we are sons. That same power that raised Jesus Christ from the dead, He is raising us to a new place. Hear me when I say, He is raising the church up to a new place. He is raising the church to a new place. A new standard is being set, and we will be believers that are so full of fire, and we will be believers that believe in the works of Jesus Christ. There will be an outbreak of miracles like we have never seen before because of the name of Jesus. People will get out of their hospital beds. Their sentences are overturned because He is the one that raises from the dead. He is the one that gives life. The Ruach, the breath of God, be breathed into you today. Mariando Selebekopaya, Andelebekopa Sundelebekopaya, Jambarapopurinendo Shatai. I pray over you that your witness will be stirred again, that you are under soul. Call lost souls into the fold again. Tell your testimony again. He is not dead. He is alive. His name is Jesus the Christ. He is the Son of God. He is the Son of God. He is the Word in flesh. He is the Messiah. He walked with men. He sat with Abraham. He laughed at Sarah. He is Genesis to Revelation. He is God. And beside Him there is no other God. His name is Jesus. 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 He will never grow old. Oh, be filled again. Right in your rooms. Right in your rooms. Right where you are. Be filled with the Holy Ghost. Be filled with the Holy Ghost again. Let there be a stirring in your spirit. Let the fire of God baptize you to witness again. Let the fire of God baptize you to testify again. Jesus Christ, He is the light of the world. If you are watching and you are not saved, if you are backslidden, I want you today where you are. Rededicate your life to the Lord. Repeat after me, Father, in the name of Jesus, I am a sinner in need of salvation. Thank you for your blood. I walked away, or I've never served you. But today, I open my heart and receive you as Lord again. I receive you as Lord again. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you that your mercy never fails. Your mercy is new every morning. Great is your faithfulness. If you have received Jesus Christ or you have rededicated your life to the Lord, I want you to let us know. Put it in our chat. Email us at evangelism@nybaltimore.com. We want to hear. We want to know your story. Tell us how this message blessed you. Bless you. May the Lord keep you. May He make His face shine upon you and be gracious unto you. And give you peace as He has promised. Amen. God bless you.